महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवस्य कार्य सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। ओम सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आप्यायन्तु भवाङ्गानि वाक्प्राणचक्षुश्रोत्रमथमन्यत् निराकरणमस्तु निराकरणं यस्तु तदात्मनः सर्वास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं येदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवम् आत्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तैकसंसिद्धम् आदिमत्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। Some more hiccup. I don't think the audio recording is working. Let me just check that out or make an audio recording. That's interesting. Device not connected. Okay. Yeah, now it should work. Something wrong with the settings. Okay. सो आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धम् आदिमत्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। एट्लीस्ट् लेट् दि मङ्गलाचरण श्लोक बी देर् इन् दि रिकार्डिङ्ग् आल्दो दि अर्लियर् वन्स् वी मिस्ड्। ओके सो सिन्स् इट्स् बीन् अ फ्यू मन्त्स् दट् वी हेड् दि लास्ट् क्लास् सिन्स् दि लास्ट् क्लास् लेट्स् डू अ लिटिल् रीकेप्। सो वी आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् भगवान् सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्रस् वृत्ति ऑन ब्रह्मसूत्र। ब्रह्मसूत्र हैज फोर पादास्। दि समन्वय पाद दि फर्स्ट चैप्टर सॉरी दि फोर अध्यायास्। समन्वय अध्याय, अविरोध अध्याय, साधन अध्याय, फल अध्याय। ईच अध्याय हैज फोर पादास्। वी हैव फिनिश्ड दि फर्स्ट पाद विच वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट दि स्पष्ट ब्रह्मलिंग वाक्यास्। So the Upanishad Spashta Brahmalinga Vakyas were dealt with in the first pada of the first adhyaya of Brahma Sutra. In the second pada, which we are looking at right now, we have finished I think 23 sutras. But it was introduced, this second pada was introduced by saying, Ittham Purvasmin Pade Spashta Brahmalinga Vakyanam Brahmani Samanvaya Sadhitaha. It is still continuing with the Samanvaya of all the Vedanta Vakyas and by extension Vedas also, Veda Vakyas also, through Karma Kanda and Upasana Kanda, leading to Chitta Shuddhi of the Karta and thereby opening up the possibility of Jnana, whereby the Karta knows that he is an akarta. He has always been an akarta, and thereby leading him to Jnana Kanda and Aikya with Brahma. So that is the samanvaya of the Upanishad Vakyas, Vedanta Vakyas complete without exception and by extension of the entire Vedas. This is the Tatparya Vishaya, Aikya, and the samanvaya Adhyaya shows this. The first pada took the vakyas which are more or less clear in the sense that they are talking about Brahma. All these vakyas have the tatparya vishaya as Brahma. And now in this pada, adhuna aspashta brahmalinganam samanvayam sadhetum dvitiya tritiya padav arabhyete. The second and the third padas of the first chapter आर गोइंग टू डील विथ अस्पष्ट ब्रह्मलिंग वाक्यास दी वेदांत वाक्यास वेर दी ब्रह्मलिंग दी वाक्यस तात्पर्य विषय बीइंग ब्रह्म इज नॉट सो क्लियर इट हैज टू बी क्लैरिफाइड देर इज मोर पूर्व पक्ष देर इज मोर पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ कंक्लूडिंग दैट दी तात्पर्य विषय इज इधर आत्मा मीनिंग जीवात्मा इंडिविजुअलाइज आत्मा और प्राण और आदित्य देवता इत्यादि बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ दीज वाक्यास आर डीलिंग विथ उपासना दे आर नॉट क्लियरली डीलिंग विथ ज्ञान दोज विच हैव उपासना एज देयर फोकस इवन देन हु इज द उपास्य देवता देयर इज इट एन इंडिविजुअल समवन इंद्र देवता प्राण इत्यादि वैश्वानराग्नि सो ऑल दीज आर पॉसिबल कंक्लूजन्स विच आर रिफ्यूटेड बाय द सिद्धांत लुकिंग इट द पूर्वपक्ष एंड देन पूर्वस्मिन् पादे जगत् कारणत्वेन व्यापित्वादिकम् अर्थसिद्धम् बाय शोइंग दैट ब्रह्मै जगत् कारण जन्माद्यस्यतः बाय दैट सूत्र जो जन्म स्थिति भंग कारण इज ब्रह्म वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड हैविंग एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट व्हाट इज अर्थात सिद्धम अर्थसिद्धम इज अर्थ व्हाट इज अर्थतः सिद्धम व्हाट इज एन इंडिकेशन व्हाट डज इट व्हाट इज अ कोरोलरी ऑफ दैट बिकॉज ब्रह्म ही जगत कारण देयरफॉर इट हैज टू बी अ व्यापक तत्व दी जगत इज कंप्लीटली परवेडेड बाय दी कारण ब्रह्म जगत इज कार्य एंड दी ब्रह्म इज कारण मैंने से कारण ब्रह्म देर इट इज दैट विच इज दी कॉज फॉर दी वर्ल्ड कंप्लीट एंड तदुपजीव्य उत्तरपादद्वयस्य उत्थानात् हेतु हेतु मद्भाव संगति अस्य पूर्वपादेन दी पाद संगति हैज बीन शोन बिकॉज देर इज सच कनेक्शन दि उपजीव्य उत्तरपाद द्वयस्य दि सेकेंड एंड दि थर्ड पाद आर उपजी बेस्ड ऑन दि अर्लियर पाद दे आर कंटिन्यूइंग देयरफॉर दे आर हैविंग हेतु हेतु मद्भाव संगति अर्लियर पाद बिकम्स दि हेतु फॉर दि सेकेंड एंड दि थर्ड पाद टू कम अप यथा पूर्वं जीवादिलिंग बाधया ब्रह्म परत्वम् उक्तम् न तथा इह मनोमयादि वाक्ये ब्रह्मलिंगमस्ति इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्ये इदम् आरभ्यते नाउ दिस इज दि specific introduction to the first sutra. We will not go into so much of detail, but the overview should be clear as to the Aspashta Brahmalinga Vakyas are looked into here primarily. There is also a possibility of some Vakyas are very clearly talking about Brahma. So here, what is said, Sarvatra Prasiddhopadeshat. The first sutra is Sarvatra Prasiddhopadeshat. Sarvatra, everywhere. Everywhere, what is the sarvatra prasiddha upadesha sarveshu vedanteshu yat prasiddham jagat karanam brahma tasyevatra sarvam khalu ityadina upadesha ityartha. So the teaching is that brahma is jagat karana, that jagat karana brahma itself has anuvritti into all vedanta vakyas such as sarvam khalu idam brahma. It is not a different Brahma, it is the same Jagat Karana Brahma which has anuvritti in Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. The entire thing is Brahma because the Prapancha is Karya, the entire Jagat is Karya and Brahma is the Karana. Karya is never separate from Karana Brahma, therefore Jagat is not separate from Brahma and therefore Sarvam Khalu Idam, Idam Sarvam, Idam Jagat, Sarvam Brahma Eva Asti. Ityadina upadeshat and such mantras are spread across the Upanishad. All those are talking about the same Brahma, not different Brahma, not Chaturmukha Brahma, not Brahmana Brahma, not Veda Brahma. Brahma has multiple meanings. None of those are applicable. It is not figurative usage. It is not a Arthavada. It is not a stuti para vakya, it is all dealing with the same Jagat Karana Brahma which was discussed elaborately in the first pada. Itascha brahmeva tropadishyate ityaha. And for this particular reason also, Brahma alone is the topic of teaching here. Vivakshita guna upapatteshcha. So, vivakshita guna upapatteshcha. Because of the tenability of what? The gunas which are vivakshita, which are intended to be conveyed. Whose gunas are intended to be conveyed? Whatever is the topic of teaching, the same gunas are discussed. No other gunas. You cannot have a topic as Brahma, Jagat Karana, Brahma, and then have the discussion of gunas which are not belonging to Brahma. They are all Brahma gunas. So, Vivakshita, Bharupa, Satyasankalpa, Ityadi, all these gunas which are there. Ishvara is Satyasankalpa, he is Bharupa. He is the one who is self-shining. All the others shine after Brahma shines forth. Brahmatma shines forth. So, vivakshitaha ye gunaha tesham brahmani eva upatteer ityartaha. The upapatti, the tenability, the logical possibility of these gunas applying to anyone else other than Brahma does not exist. What is the possible conclusion? If you analyze properly Bharupa and Satyasankalpa, ityadi shabdas, ityadi gunas, the shabdas which describe the gunas, they are applicable only with respect to Brahma. Then, nanu viparitam kimna syad iti chet na ityaha. Why can't it be other way around? Meaning, jiva sadharana, Bharupa jiva is also Manomaya. So there are other gunas also discussed, not only Bharupa, Satyasankalpa. Based on Bharupa, Satyasankalpa, ityadi, yogi can be Satyasankalpa. Whatever Sankalpa, Satyasankalpa means whatever Sankalpa has been taken, that comes to a proper conclusion. It becomes Satya. It turns out to be true. Whatever words have been uttered, as simple as that, Sankalpa is words have been uttered that let this be. And such a thing comes true. That is possible even for a yogi who is a siddha. It is a siddhi. Bharupa is possible for a person who is doing japa upasana ityadi, and thereby there is Brahma Tejas. Brahma Tejas is seen by others. It is not that it is a person has a feeling. On the mukha itself, Brahma Tejas is seen. You look at a person and you say, look at the look how brilliance is there on his face. Others would call it as aura, you know. You feel the aura or whatever. So, these are possible with respect to jiva also. Jiva sadharanasya manomayatvadehe. Manomayatvam is anyway common. Manomaya is jiva. Need not necessarily be Ishvara. Jiva possibility is there. Therefore, viparitam kimna syat. Viparitam means Brahma viparita artha kinna syat. Why can't you take jiva as the meaning instead of Brahma in those vakyas also? Bharupa, Satyasankalpa, ityadi. There the response given is anupapattes tu na shariraha. Shariraha jivaha. Sharira, sharire bhavaha shariraha. One who is in the sharira is jiva, is Ishvara also, but then jiva, because of the sharira no longer being an upadhi, it becomes a visheshana. So when the sharira becomes a visheshana, one takes oneself as the sharira, the sharira traya, one identifies, and thereby the same Ishvara who is anena jivatmana anupravishya, the same Jagatkarta Ishvara who has entered the Sharira ceases to be Ishvara as though and becomes a Samsari Jiva. That Jiva is called as Shariraha. So, Viparitam Kimna Syat, meaning why can't you take Bharupa Satya Sankalpa as Shariraha Jiva? No, it is not possible, says the Siddhanti. Why? Anupapattehe, what is that? Satya Sankalpatvadi Naam Jive Samanjasyena Anupapatte. In its entirety, all the gunas will apply only to Paramatma, not to Jiva. therefore na shariraha. The viparita, brahma viparita, sharira jiva cannot be taken as the meaning in these Vedanta Vakyas, because the upasya dharmas which are talked about even in the upasana mantras, they apply only to brahma, they cannot apply to jiva. A limited entity cannot take this satya sankalpatva ityadi. One off maybe you say satya sankalpatva you can show in some jiva somewhere who has done a lot of sadhana, who has got yoga siddhi, vibhutis are there. All those vibhutis are also manifestations of the same Ishvara. Bhagavan Krishna says in Gita, wherever there is even an iota of vibhuti, that is mama eva, he says, in the vibhuti pada, in the vibhuti yoga adhyaya. Itaschana sharira upasetya. And the upasya devata cannot be sharira for this reason also. Why? Karma kartrya padeshacha. The jiva is the karta. What is the vishaya of that upasaka jiva? The upasana vishaya, he is doing upasana. So there is a triputi. Upasaka, upasya and upasana. So the upasaka karta jiva, sharira jiva, is doing upasana. That upasana vishaya, which is the karma of the upasana, that is the upasya devata. That cannot be the sharira karta himself. The upasaka, upasana karta, upasaka cannot be the upasana karma upasya as well. What has been taught is that this upasaka should do upasana on some other entity. That cannot be the same limited jiva. So, etam itaf pretya abhisambhavitasmi. Etam itaf pretya abhisambhavitasmi. Ityanena etam iti prakritya. Etam is the karma. It is the second case. It is the dvitiya vibhakti. So there the manomayatvadi gunaka upasya devata is who? It has to be brahma. So brahmana karmatvena prapyatvena, that has to be attained. Jiva cannot say that I'll attain myself. There is a karma kartru virodha also. If you say that jiva is the upasaka as well as upasya, it cannot be so. Therefore the prapya cannot be the upasaka. The prapya is the upasya, different from the upasaka, and this is how it has been taught in the Upanishad Vakyas there. Kartrutvena vipadishya manatva ityartha. Sharirasya kartrutvena. Sharirasya upasakasya jivasya kartrutvena vipadesha. The teaching is that the karta is upasaka. He has to do upasana on the upasya, which is not this karta. Cannot be this karta. Therefore, Brahma is the manomayatvadi satya sankalpatva bharupatva ityadi gunakasya vyapadeshat upasyatvena vyapadeshat there karmatvena. So the upasya brahma is karma. So sharirasya kartrutvena vyapadeshat and upasya brahmanah with all those gunas karmatvena upasyatvena karmatvena vyapadeshat. Namaste. Oh, is that right? Oh, thanks for the call. Let me see what happened. Oh, it looks like the internet dropped off. Let me put it on mobile. Thanks for the call. Yeah. Oh, am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay, so I'll continue this. So I think this karma kartru yapadeshat, this I had started. Was this audible over here?
It was audible when you started.
Okay. So I was saying itaschana sharira upasetyah. So for this reason also, the sharira cannot be the upasya, because sharira jiva, Sharire Bhava Sharira Jiva is taught as Upasaka, who is Karta of the Upasana. So in the Triputi of Karta, Karma and Kriya, meaning Upasaka, Upasya and Upasana Kriya, there the Karta is the Upasaka Jiva, Sharira Jiva. He himself cannot be the Upasya. So etam, that second case, etam itaf pretya abhisambhavita asmi, there etam iti prakrutasya manomayatvadi gunasya brahmanaha karmatvena prapyatvena vyapadeshat. So the prapya upasya is that which has to be attained, cannot be the same karta upasaka. So that is what I was saying. Anyway, I am assuming that it is recorded, and if some more details are needed, can look up. Therefore, karma kartru vyapadeshacha. Karma is the upasya brahma, and karta is the upasaka jiva sharira. Himself cannot be the karma. There is a kartru karma virodha also. Therefore, it has to be brahma, meaning the upasya has to be brahma. Itaschana sharira upasya. Why cannot the sharira jiva be upasya? Another reason is given, shabda visheshat. So shabda vishesha is there, purusha shabdaha. There, samana prakarane antaratman purusho hiranmayaha iti sharirasya yaha shabda abhidhayaka. What has been taught in that mantra, another mantra, purusha shabda has been used there, antaratman purushaha. What is that antaratman purushaha hiranmayaha? That hiranmaya is upasya, cannot be sharira. Why? Antaratman. That antaratman is antaratmani, saptami. So saptamyantaha yaha shabda sharirasya yaha shabda abhidhayakaha saptamyanta antaratman iti. Antaratman is saptami, chandasa prayoga, antaratmani ityartha. In the antaratman, inside the shariraha, meaning sharire jive antaratmani, यह पुरुषा हिरण्मयः सह उपास्यः. दैट हिरण्मय पुरुषा हु इज विद इन द शरीर जीव, हु इज विद इन, कैनॉट बी द सेम एंटिटी. यू कैनॉट हैव जीवा एज आधार एज वेल एज आधेय. सो द आधार जीव इज द उपासक, इन हुम देर इज पुरुषा हु हैज टू बी मेडिटेटेड अपॉन, हु इज द उपास्य विषय, उपासना विषय, उपास्य देवता. सो पुरुष शब्द, दैट शब्द विशेष इज देयर इन द मंत्र. देयरफॉर तस्य पुरुष पुरुष शब्दस्य सत्वात् द शरीर इज कैनॉट बी द उपास्य. द परमात्मा अलोन इज उपास्य. किंच स्मृतेश्च, देन देयर इज आल्सो स्मृति सपोर्ट to show that the Shruti has been interpreted properly. You can take support from Shruti also and show that there is no contradiction. Ishvara sarvabhutanam hriddeshi arjuna tishtati brahmen sarvabhutani yantra rudani mayaya, says Bhagavan Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. As to Jiva and Paramatma are not one in Upasana. It is not Ahangra Upasana here. So Ishvara is there in the Hriddesha of all Bhutas, and he is the inner controller, as though making a puppet show out of these Jivas. He is Yantra Rudani, as though, you know, Yantra is a motorized also, you can say, in the modern world. So moved by the controller. The controller motor moves all the jivas. That controlling motor is the Paramatma Tattva, who is Upasya. So, na parasmad anyaha jiva upasya iti siddham. Here, through these sutras, it has been established that the Upasya Devata is Paramatma, not individualized jivatma. Now, another thing is Jiva Paramatmanur Bheda Smaranat. Since there is a Smriti Gita, there is a Smarana in Gita, as Jiva and Paramatma are different. If that is the case, then what is the point of calling ourselves Advaitins? So there, भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेंद्र सेज अनयोर भेदस्तु काल्पनिकः इन उपासना द उपासना इज ऑल इज फॉर नॉट ओनली चित्त शुद्धि कर्म गिव्स यू चित्त शुद्धि बट उपासना गिव्स यू अ फोकस्ड माइंड दैट फोकस्ड माइंड इज नीडेड शुरस्य धारा एज कठोपनिषद सेज दैट बुद्धि शुड बी सो शार्प दैट इट शुड कट थ्रू ऑल ऑब्जेक्शंस यूजिंग बुद्धि एज अ टूल द साधका शुड बी एबल टू कट थ्रू ऑल आक्षेपास टू अद्वैत नाउ जीव परमात्मा भेद हैज बीन शोन इन स्मृति एंड दिस इज द सूत्र इटसेल्फ ब्रह्म सूत्र सेज द देर इज अ टीचिंग ऑफ भेद इन गीता ऑल्सो विच इज derived from the Vedanta Upanishad. So Upanishad Vakyas are showing Bheda. Where are they showing Bhedas? In the Upasana Kanda. Why are they showing Bhedas in the Upasana or Jnana Kanda also where the teaching is handholding? It is handholding the sadhaka who is already in the Dvaita Prapancha who has to be taken to Advaita as an end goal. Therefore, the Bheda is taught. Definitely it is taught. But what is it? Anayoho Bhedaha. Anayoho Kayoho. Jiva Paramatmanoho Bhedastu Kalpanikaha. It is imagined because one is already living that imagination. Each and every Jiva, since Anadikala, has been living this imagination itself. Na vastava iti rahasyam. This rahasya is finally Upanishad. Upanishad, another meaning for Upanishad is rahasya. So the teaching is not over yet. The handholding is only to bring out the person from this swapna and drag this person out so that he reaches the Advaita, which is the goal. Then what is going on in the further 7th sutra onwards? Aduna Paramatmana Upasyatvam Akshipya Pariharati. Is there a possibility of this Paramatma as Upasya? If at all the Upanishad mantra says that he is in Hruddesha, because Ishvara Sarvabhutaram Hruddesha Arjuna Tishtati is also Smriti conclusion. In Hruddesha, how can you have? In the Hrudaya Akasha, in the Hridaya Desha, which is limited space, how can you have this Vyapaka Tattva, which is how you opened up your second chapter, Upodghata. The introduction itself showed that there is a Vyapaka Tattva because Brahma is Jagat Karana and that indicates Vyapaka Tattva. This Vyapaka Tattva cannot be in Hridesha, is the Aropana, Akshipya Pariharati. अर्भकौकस्त्वात् तद्व्यपदेशाच्चनेति चेन् न निचायत्वात् एवं व्योमवच्च व्योमवच्च जस्ट लाइक आकाश आकाश इज देयर एज अ व्यापक तत्व ऑल ओवर नो दार्शनिका इज गोइंग टू क्वेश्चन दैट आकाश इज ऑल ओवर इन ऑल देश इज इट देयर इन हृदेश ऑल्सो और इन घटा विद इन घटा घटाकाश Similarly, just like Ghatakasha is a possibility, although Akasha is a Vyapaka Tattva, is the Vyapaka Tattva. Similarly, this Arbhakauka, Arbhakam is Alpam. Arbhaka, there is Arbhaka Okaha. Oka is Tana. Yasya sa Arbhakaukaha. So the Paramatma who has a limited Hriddesha kind of a limited Sthana is अर्भकौकस्त्वात् तद्व्यपदेशाच्च सिंस दिस परमात्मा यू आर क्लेमिंग एज परमात्मा सेज द पूर्व पक्षी इज इन अ लिमिटेड स्पेस इट कैनॉट बी परमात्मा बिकॉज परमात्मा कैनॉट बी इन सच अ स्मॉल स्पेस लाइक द हार्ट एष आत्मा अंतर्हृदये दैट अंतर्हृदये एज द मंत्र एंड In Smriti as Hruddeshe Arjuna Tishtati, that Paramatma, that entity cannot be Paramatma is the claim by the Purva Bhakshi. Iti Parichinna Hridayayatana Hridayayatanatvad. The Parichinna Hridayayatanatvad ityartaha. This Parichinna space, very limited space, cannot be holding this Paramatma who is Vyapakatattva. But then Siddhanti says Vyomavaccha. It has been taught in that nichayatvad. It has been taught in that manner for upasana. Vyapadeshaccha swashabdena aniyan. Aniyan is also used. Mahato mahiyan and aniyan also. He is small, not only huge but also small. Small in the sense subtle. Aragramatraha. All these are possible as per upasana. For upasana, it has been shown that although this vyapaka tattva is there, how do you imagine such infinite limitless tattva? It is not possible for a limited mind to imagine something limitless. Infinity is not possible to be understood by regular means. Even in mathematics, infinity, although you can put a symbol, but it is very difficult. It is a difficult concept to understand. What is infinity? Whatever you can think of, whatever you can imagine, whatever a sum total of people can imagine, the best of the mathematicians and scientists, it is more than that. Atyatishtad dashangulam. In Purusha Sukta, whatever this entire prapancha or the universe which is expansive, ever expanding is, Purusha is 10 fingers above. How can it be? The entire Desha is included in the universe. But if you say it is an ever-expanding, then Desha cannot be included. It is ever-expanding universe outside the space as we know. And then thus the universe is expanding into that unknown space also. You have to imagine that there is a space beyond. If you imagine that there is a space beyond, Paramatma is beyond that by 10 fingers. Then it's just a, you know, it's a upalakshana for limitlessness basically. Very difficult to understand concept. Therefore, what Upasana Kanda does, the mantras help you imagine the infinite as a parichinna tattva. One who can never be limited, that is imagined as limited. Again, a kalpana is made for Upasana so that we derive benefit out of it. It is all a kalpana. So, na sarvagata paramatma iti chet, their answer is na, why? Nichayatvad evam. It has been taught in this manner. Upasyatva, nichayatvad means upasyatvad. Since it has been taught, this paramatma has been taught as being upasya in this manner. In hriddesha, if you do upasana, then you will get a certain phala. Which is a phala committed by the phalashruti in the upasana kanda. And if we don't claim that phala, it will lead to ekagrata, which will lead to jnana kanda. And drishtanta has been given vyomavat. Vyomavat means akashavat. Just like akasha, you can be imagined in being in a limited space, although it is not limited. Similarly, paramatma also can be imagined to be limited for upasana ityadi. Sambhoga praptiriti chen na vaisheshya. So here the introduction is, अधुना परमात्मना सर्वगतत्वे दोषम आशंक्य परिहरति. If at all you say the Paramatma is limitless, who is imagined as being in Hriddesha, now there is another objection. Is it literally so that Paramatma is limitless and in each and every Hridaya he is there? If it is true that Paramatma is Sarvagata and available in each and every jiva. Sarvabhutanam hruddeshe arjuna tishtati. If the Paramatma tattva, the Paramatma himself is there in hruddesha of each and every bhuta, sarvabhutanam, then what about the sambhoga of the jiva? Each and every jiva has sambhoga. That bhoga will be there for whoever is there in that hriddesha also. So, Ishvara will also have that sambhoga. Iti chet, sambhoga praptir, Ishvarasya paramatmana sambhoga praptir iti chet. Sarvagatasya Ishvarasya paramatmana sambhoga praptir iti chet. If at all Paramatma is sarvagata, then he is available in each and every jiva, then he associates with each and every jiva sukha dukha, then he will become a samsari. This is the akshepa. Iti chet na vaisheshyat. No, there is a vaisheshya. Why? why won't there be sambhoga prapti, sukha dukkha prapti for Ishvara like Jiva? Because just like Akasha shown earlier, Akasha is available in each and every space, each and every ghata also. If you put garlic in one ghata and keep it, then the space within, Akasha within that ghata is not going to get tainted by that smell. It will not have that smell. The garlic smell will be there in the pot, in the particles of the pot, in the particles that travel to your nose. But the Akasha which is there limited by this ghata also, which is holding the garlic, that Akasha will not be tainted. Similarly, Paramatma will not have any Sukha-Dukha, although he is there in each and every Jiva. So, Sukha-Dukha Anubhava Rupa Sambhoga Praptireti Che Jivavat Paramatmanaha Na. Why? Vaisheshyat Jiva Paramatmanaho Bhoktrutva Abhoktrutva Adi Visheshat. There is a difference between Jiva and Paramatma. This is a very definition that Jiva is a Bhokta, Karta Bhokta. And akarta abhokta is Ishvara. There should also be a possibility. Just like Akasha has no possibility of having the smell being associated, similarly, Ishvara has no possibility. Paramatma has no possibility of karma and karma phala sticking to him. There is no possibility. So therefore, Paramatma is Upasya. Meaning, what has been shown is that through this doubt, what Purvapakshi wanted to show is that what it means is that it is not that Paramatma who is there in the Hriddesha. And if through this objection had he shown that, oh, if this flaw of Sukha Dukkha being associated with Paramatma cannot be refuted, then it is not the Paramatma who is there in the Hriddesha, which means that he will go back to the earlier claim as Jiva is Upasya, Sharira, not Paramatma. Since this has been refuted that Ishvara cannot have Sukha Dukkha Bhoga, therefore in Hriddesha it is Ishvara alone who is Upasya. Now, just like Bhoktrutva Bhava is there, Kartrutva Bhava is also there for Brahma. That is shown by in the next Atradikaranam. So, Atta. Atta charachara grahanat. So, who is the Atta? The Atta Adhanakarta, the one who consumes everyone, is Paramatma. Siddhantastu Paramatma eva, not the Jiva or Agni. So, here you know, in the Atra Purvapakshe Agnehe Jivasya va Upasti. In Purvapaksha, the conclusion is that Agni or Jiva is Upasya, whereas Nirvishesha Brahma, Nirguna Brahma is to be known. Brahma Dhi in Siddhanta, Siddhanta Nirvishesha Brahma Dhi, it is not even Upasana, but it is understanding of the Nirguna Brahma. Where in Kathavalli you have Yasya Brahma Chakshatrancha, Ubhe Bhavata Odanaha, Ityadi. That mantra shows that the Paramatma is Atta. Who is the Atta? If it is Upasana or understanding, who is to be understood there as Atta? The Atta is Paramatma as per the Siddhanti, but Purvapakshi is Agni. Agni consumes everything. Alamna vidyate asya analaha. That anala, Agnihi, is the Upasya because it consumes everything, but it is not true. Brahma cha kshatran cha, Brahma, Brahmana and Kshatriya also have been talked about there, and Mrityu Bhavati Upasechana. There Mrityu Yamaraja is Upasechana, is a side dish. So there Chara and Achara both are being talked about. It is not only Achara. Agni consumes only Achara. Agni cannot consume sentience. In the Antyeshti also, Sharira is offered. Atma cannot be offered. But here, figuratively also, what has been talked about as being consumed. Meaning, one who rules over and has control complete over the sentient beings, just like insentient also, sthavara jangamayoho, adhyatvena asmin vakye grahanat, characharayo, the characharay is sthavara and jangama, the moving and immoving, immovable also, and then sentience by extension is being controlled. How it is it being controlled? Because the sentience which is associated with a limited being becomes a controlled. All that is possible only for Paramatma, not for Agni as a Devata or Jiva. Jiva Bahuduram. Even if for Agni Devata itself it is not possible, then for Jiva it is anyway impossible. Itascha Paramatma eva atta ityaha. Why else is Paramatma the consumer there, karta? Prakaranachya. The prakarana, the context is like that. Na jayate mriyate va vipaschityadina Paramatmanah prakaranat. The context has already been set as one who is never born, does not die, meaning does not have any of the shadvikaras, that is Paramatma. Ka ittha veda yatra sa iti durvijnyetva rupa asadharana lingachya ityartha. So cha has been said. So prakaranachya. There is a Brahmalinga, there is no possibility of it being Agni Ityadi. Sorry. Then, Guha Pravishta Adhikaranam. Here, Guham Pravishta Vatmanav hi Taddarshanat. Puram Brahmakshatra Pradasya Mrityupada Sanidhyad Anitya Vastu Paratva Vad Iha Api Pivachabdasya Sanhita Guha Praveshadina बुद्धि क्षेत्रज्ञ बुद्धि क्षेत्रज्ञ परत्वमस्तु इति दृष्टांत संगत्य इदमः. सो पूर्व पक्षी सेज दैट इन दी ऋतम पिबंतौ सुकृतस्य लोके देयर इज दिस मंत्र. सो इन दैट मंत्र वन इज बुद्धि द अदर इज क्षेत्रज्ञ. जस्ट लाइक ब्रह्मक्षत्र पदा हैव बीन यूज्ड एंड यू हैव शोन दैट Charachara grahana has to, the Charachara atta has to be Paramatma. So here, who are the ones which who are talked about as those who have entered the Guha? In the Guha, in the Jiva, Rupa Guha, in the Antakkarana really. Pravishtav Atmanav hi Taddarshanat. So are they Atmas, meaning Jivatma and Paramatma, or they are Buddhi and Kshetrajna? Purva Pakshi says, Buddhi Bhinna Jiva Jnanam. Here, Buddhi Bhinna Jiva Jnanam. Buddhi and other than that Jiva, meaning what? Buddhi and Kshetrajna. Kshetrajna is Jiva, Kshetram Jnanati iti Kshetrajna, Jiva, Sharira. And Buddhi is anyway Buddhi, Antakkarana. So Antakkarana is one part of the Jiva Sharira, and the Jiva is separate from this Antakkarana, from this Buddhi. This Jivatma Kshetrajna is different. Buddhi is part of the Kshetra. Kshetrajna Jiva is separate from it. This is the teaching given there, says the Purva Pakshi. We do not dispute the fact that such teaching is there, but this mantra is not about that. This mantra, Rutam Pibanto Sukrutasya Loke, is not talking about this single entity who is Buddhi, Antakkarana, and the other entity which is Jiva. It is not talking about that. Why? Because Pibantau, there Antakkarana cannot be Pibat and Atma as Piban. Both are Atma alone. Both are sentient beings. Buddhi is insentient. It cannot be Pibat. Pibati or Pibanti Buddhi, it cannot be. It has to be sentient entity who is partaking of the phala. Whereas the other is not really partaking, is watching over. So that is the context there. And thereby, Siddhante tu Jiva Vilakshana Paramatma Jnanam iti Phalabheda Paramatma Jnanam. There the Buddhi Bhinna Jiva is not being taught, but Jiva Bhinna Paramatma is being taught. Both are sentient, but among these sentient beings there is a difference. Jiva who is limited is different from the Paramatma who is limitless. That Paramatma is to be known. And once you know that Paramatma, then you will know that Jiva is no longer separate from the Paramatma, he is one with him, one with Paramatma. So that is a context. Therefore, Guham Pravishtau Jiva Paramatmanau Eva. Why? Kutaha Atmanau hi. He Yasmad Atmanau Chetanau. Chetanas are being talked about. One is Achetana Buddhi, who the Purvapakshi claims is one of the Pibantau, and the other is Jivatma. That cannot be. Rutam Pibantau iti karma phala bhoga shravanena ekasya atmatve dvitiyasya api atmatvam nyayam. If one is Atma because it is the karma phala, it is showing the karma phala bhoga shravana. Whether really there is a karma phala bhokta or not is a different story. But isn't the mantra talking about karma phala bhoga? If the or a bhogi, so there is karma phala bhoga shravana in the mantra. And when you say pibantu iti dvivachanam, there rutam pibantu karma phala pibantau dvivachana is there, iti dvivachana is there, that dvivachana is talking about two sentient beings, two chetana vastu. You cannot have one achetana and the other chetana. So ekasya atmatve, meaning ekasya chetana atmatve dvitiyasya api atmatvam nyayam. So it, other also chetanatvam nyayam. You cannot have one achetana buddhi and the other as chetana. One is chetana, the other also has to be chetana in the dvivachana there. Tatra hetu taddarshanat. Because this is how it has been seen in the loka also. Sankhyashravane. We saw the example Sankhyashravane as given in the vritti. Sankhyavatoho ekarupatvasya loke darshana ityartha. If someone talks about ghatamanaya and then he say bring another, dvitiyam api anaya, then second, ghata has to be brought in. You cannot bring a cow. Similarly, if you say gama anaya, then anya api anaya, if he says, then the other also has to be cow. You cannot have one cow and one pot. In either case, if the pot has been asked for, the other also has to be pot. If the sentient cow has been talked about, then the second one has to be the sentient cow. It cannot be any sentient other also, but definitely not ghata. As insentient, you cannot have. Therefore, both talk about Atma. Itascha jiva paramatmano eva guham pravishta vityaha. What is the other reason? Visheshanacha. There is a visheshana given. What is the visheshana? Sodhvana paramapnoti devam matvadhiro harshashokau jahati. So all these are gantrugantavya bhavenacha visheshizatvadityartha. So Jiva and Paramatma have been talked about in a single prakarana, ekasmin prakarane, asmin prakarane, asmin ekasmin eva prakarane. In the same context, what has been talked about? Gantru gantavya. The Jiva is ganta and the gantavya prapya is the same hetu which has been seen earlier. Advara param apnoti, Jiva apnoti, Paramatmanam apnoti. Advara param is what? Beyond all this. Beyond all this is Paramatma, that Paramatmanam apnoti gantavyatvena. So gantavya bhavena is gantavyatvena, gantrutvena gantavyatvena cha. Jivasya gantrutvena Paramatmanaha gantavyatvena cha visheshitatva. They have been separated out as one is the karta who is going to reach and other is the karma which is reached. Paramatma is the karma which is reached, whereas Jiva is the upasaka who is the reacher, who is the traveller. Therefore, we talk about gati of the upasaka ityadi. We talk about the gati. Let him get good gati. Let her get good gati. All that is what? It is a jiva who is not going to attain oneself. Then, antara adhikarana, antara upapattehe, atra purvapakshe, pratibimba upasti. The pratibimba who is seen in the akshi. Akshi, akshin, in the akshin, in the eye, in the right eye, there is someone upasya, one who is available in the eye. Purvapakshi says, who is available in the eye? The reflection. The reflection has to be somebody who is in front of the jiva upasaka. So pratibimba is upasti, is the upasya devata. Whoever is in the front, siddhante brahma upastiriti phalavedaha. So whoever is in the front or whoever is reflecting, it is a jiva who is reflecting, says the Purvapakshi. Whereas brahma is reflecting in the eye all the time. Brahma is there all the while. whereas Pratibimba comes and goes. Pratibimba is not one who is Upasya, but Siddhanta says that Brahma is Upasya. Why? Antaraha, Siddhantastu Antaraha, Akshimadhyagata Paramatma eva Upadishyate, Kutaha Upapattehe. Since that is the only possibility, Upapatti there is logical tenability. Atmatva Amrutatva Abhayatvadinam Iha Uktanam Paramatmanyeva Upapattehe. It is not that Jiva has been talked about as Amruta, Abhaya, Ityadi. All these are applicable only to Paramatma. The Abhaya, Abhaya Tattva, Abhaya Pradata is Paramatma. Amruta Tattva, Amrutatva Pradata is Paramatma Tattva. He is the one who is being talked about as Akshigata Purusha. It is not the Jiva who is himself Akshigata. Nanu sarvagatasya alpam akshisthanam na sambhavati. Same objection. Hriddeshe Paramatma cannot be there. Similarly, now Purvapakshi says, in akshisthana also, Paramatma cannot be there in such a limited space. Sthana adhyapadeshaccha. Iti Purvapaksha bijam dushayitumaha. Itamaha sthana adhyapadeshaccha. This sthana is being talked about. Does not mean that Paramatma is limited there. He is being imagined there, so that the Upasaka gets the Upasana Phala. Yat Chakshushi Tishtan. So one who is there Sarvagata, Saha Eva Chakshushi Tishtan. That is Sthana. He is residing in the Chakshu, just like what? The name given, Hiranyashmashruhu, one who has the golden mustache. All that is imagined, all these gunas are imagined for an Arupi Ishvara. One who does not have Rupa to such a Devata, we do some Alankara and then see that, okay, this is how I can meditate upon that Bhagavan. So, Sthanadiyapadeshaccha kim? Paramatmaya upasya. Akshigata also Paramatma eva upasya. Sukha Vishishta Abhidhanad eva cha. Then Sukha Vishishta Abhidhanad. What is the objection? Prakranad api akshistaha Paramatma eva upadishyate tyaha. Because of the context also, the one who is taught as upasya in the eye, right eye, is Paramatma alone. Why? Sukha Vishishta Abhidhanad eva cha. There has been a teaching, prano brahma, kam brahma, kham brahma, iti vakyopakrame shruyamanam, yat sukha vishishtam brahma, tasya eva iha abhidhanad ityartha. The same entity is being named. Same brahma is being talked about, which has been in the opening statement as what? Prana brahma, that prana is brahma, but not only prana brahma, because jiva prana dharane, one can say, oh, this jiva is being talked about. No, kam brahma, kham brahma, that kam is sukham. Sukham Brahma, Sukha Vishishta Brahma. Sukha is not the Sharira Swarupa. It is not the Sharira's Swarupa who is a limited Shariri. The limited Shariri, Jiva, cannot be called as Sukha Swarupa. Only the limitless Ashariri, who has given up the jivatva, that jiva who has given up the jivatva, who remains atma, not jivatma. Jivatma is a qualified atma. He becomes paramatma when he does tyaga of that jivatva bhava. Then only he is really in swarupa, sukha swarupa. Otherwise, yat sukha visishtam tad brahma eva. Brahma tasya eva iha abhidana. That kam brahma is sukha, sukha rupa brahma. That sukha rupa brahma, jiva is not. If the Purvapakshi questions, why can't it not be Jiva? The answer is very simple. Then why are you doing Upasana? If you are Sukha Rupa, you know that you are Sukha itself. Then what are you searching in this Upasana? It is clearly that through Upasana, one wants to have Sukha. In Samadhi there is Sukha. In Brahmaloka there is Sukha. In Swarga there is Sukha. In every Loka above this Mrityuloka, there is more Sukha than there is here. That is the whole reason for Upasana also. That is the whole reason for each and every activity. आत्मनस्तु कामाय सर्वं प्रियं भवति. ऑल दैट प्रियत्वम हियर एंड एल्सवेयर इज ड्यू टू फॉर आत्मा इटसेल्फ, आत्मकाम. एंड इफ द पर्सन नोज दैट ओ आई एम ऑलरेडी सुखरूपा, देन व्हाई वुड एनीवन डू उपासना एट ऑल. देयरफॉर प्राणो ब्रह्म कं ब्रह्म खं ब्रह्म इति वाक्योपक्रमे श्रूयमाणं यत् सुखविशिष्टं ब्रह्म, दैट ब्रह्म अलोन इज टॉक्ड अबाउट एज उपास्य फर्दर इन दि उपनिषद छांदोग्य तस्यैव इह अभिधानाद् इत्यर्थः. प्रकरणाद् आक्षिस्तस्य ब्रह्मत्वं विधाय लिंगादपि तदाह. देन देयर इज लिंग आल्सो, इट इज नॉट ओनली प्रकरण, देयर इज आल्सो लिंग प्रमाण. श्रुतोपनिषत् गत्यभिधानाच्च, द श्रुता वन हु हैज हर्ड द उपनिषद, व्हाट इज द श्रुता उपनिषद, रहस्यम ब्रह्म विज्ञानम यस्य स तथा, दैट इज श्रुतोपनिषत् मीन द उपासका एज वेल एज द ज्ञानी इज हु, ही इज वन हु हैज हर्ड एंड अंडरस्टूड द उपनिषद. हर्ड इज नॉट जस्ट हियरिंग, इट इज नॉट ओनली लिसनिंग ऑल्सो, यू हियर फ्रॉम वन ईयर एंड गिव अप, नॉट दैट, यू लिसन एंड रिटेन मेमोराइज, नॉट दैट, बट वॉट इज अंडरस्टूड, दैट पर्सन इज वॉट श्रुतोपनिषत् क. वॉट इज हिज गति देन, इफ ही हैज नॉट कंक्लूडेड हिज जर्नी हियर एंड बिकम अ जीवन मुक्ता, देन हिज गति इज ब्रह्मलोक, वेदर इज एन उपासक ब्रह्म उपासक और ही इज ब्रह्मज्ञानी लैकिंग अनुभूति, बाधकाज आर देर, दि निधिध्यासन वॉज नॉट कंप्लीट और श्रवण इट्सेल्फ वॉज नॉट फ्रक्टिफाइंग इन टू जीवन मुक्ति, देन द पर्सन विल हैव ब्रह्मलोक गति. इफ द पर्सन हैज डन उपासना एंड अंडर और हैज अ ज्ञानी, एज अ ज्ञानी ही अंडरस्टूड ओनली जीव तत्व एज बींग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम बुद्धि, आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम बुद्धि, आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम शरीर, ऑल राइट, यू आर डिफरेंट, दैट इज ऑल राइट, बट देन इफ दैट इज द ओनली कंक्लूजन ही हैज रीच्ड और ही हैज डन एन उपासना ऑन जीव, देन हाउ कैन ही गेट ब्रह्मलोक, बिकॉज यदुपास्यम तदेव फलम. द मर्जिंग इज विद द उपास्य देवता, द उपास्य देवता इफ जीवा, जीवा के नॉट मर्ज विद जीवा हिमसेल्फ, इफ द जीवा हैज डन उपासना ऑन अग्नि, ही कैन मर्ज विद अग्नि, बट वाई विल ही गेट ब्रह्मलोक, ही कैनॉट गेट ब्रह्मलोक. सो देवन देवयानाख्या या गति ही तस्य ब्रह्मविदः, ब्रह्मविदः कैन बी ब्रह्म उपासक एज वेल ब्रह्मज्ञानी हु इज नॉट अटेन्ड कंप्लीट ज्ञान, मीनिंग देर वेर सम ऑब्स्टैकल्स. या गति ही देवयानाख्या अथ उत्तरेण तपसा ब्रह्मचरण इत्यादि श्रुतौ, ऑल दैट एंड इन दि स्मृति ऑल्सो वॉट इज प्रसिद्ध तस्या गते इहापि आदित्या चंद्रमसम इत्यादो अभिधानाद. सो अक्षिस्तस्य ब्रह्मत्वं निश्चीयते इत्यर्थः, बिकॉज इन दि अक्षिस्थाना हु इज उपास्य हैज टू बी ब्रह्म, बिकॉज दि फला इज ब्रह्मलोक. यू कैन रिवर्स इंजीनियर वॉट एवर इज दि फला, इफ यू अंडरस्टूड दिस इज दि फला, वॉट यू रिवर्स इज दि उपास्य. यू कैन रिवर्स एंड सी दि वॉट इज द अटेनमेंट, दैट अटेनमेंट इज ऑफ ब्रह्मलोक, देयरफॉर ब्रह्म हैज टू बी उपास्य. सो थ्रू दि अदर वे एनालिसिस ऑल्सो यू कैन रीच ऑन द कंक्लूजन दैट इट इज नॉट जीवा हु इज उपास्य बट ब्रह्म. इत्थं सिद्धांतम अभिधाय पूर्वपक्षं प्रत्याह अनवस्थितेर असंभवाच्च नेतरः. इफ एट ऑल यू थिंक दैट इट इज जीवा हु इज अक्षिगत, ही इज उपास्य और प्रतिबिंब ऑफ अनदर हु इज स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम, ऑल दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. वाई? बिकॉज अनवस्थानात् असंभवाच्च, देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ समवन हु इज देर इन द फ्रंट ऑफ द आई, मीनिंग यू कॉल समवन एंड से आई डू उपासना, प्लीज स्टैंड हियर, लेट देर बी प्रतिबिंब, आई लुक एट दैट प्रतिबिंब एंड डू उपासना. इट इज ऑल नॉट पॉसिबल, अनवस्थान. यू कैनॉट हैव समवन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड द सेम एंटिटी ओवर एंड ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन, हु एवर इट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑल द वाइल. सो रिडिक्युलस, इट इज बेसिकली द कंक्लूजन इट सेल्फ इज रिडिक्युलस देर. एंड असंभवाच्च बिकॉज अमृतत्वादि गुण, ऑल द अमृतत्व सत्य संकल्पत्व एल्सवेयर और हियर इन दि इन दिस प्रकरण इट सेल्फ अमृतत्व इत्यादि गुण विच आर टॉक्ड अबाउट, देर इज अदर गुण ऑल्सो विच वॉज मेन्शन अमृतत्व एंड देन अमृतत्व एंड देन आत्मत्व अमृतत्व अभयत्व इत्यादि. सो ऑल दीज अभयत्व, ऑल दीज गुणाज आर एप्लीकेबल ओनली टू ब्रह्म, देयरफॉर असंभवाच्च. एंड देन अंतर्याम यधिकरण, अंतर्याम यधि दैवादिषु तद्धर्म व्यपदेशा. हु इज दिस अंतर्यामी, हु इज इनर कंट्रोलर, who is there in basically antaryami, adhidaiva adishu, in all of this adhyatma, adhidaiva, adhibhuta, who is there? So adhidaiva, adhyatma, adhibhuta, in all of those antaryami, the inner control is who? Tadharmayopadeshach, it has to be Brahma. Antaryami is Brahma because he is controlling everyone, everything, all the three aspects, not only one aspect. And the jiva barely has control over himself, let alone others. So, let alone any single other. What to talk about? The entire prapancha of full of all these adhidaiva, adhibhuta, adhyatma, all these three put together. It is just impossible to even imagine in upasana that I am that kind of an entity. What is the Purapaksha? There Animadi. Tatra antaryami pradhanam. Pradhanam says the Sankhya. Uta animadi vishishta jiva says, say yogi or someone else. Uta aho paramatma iti vishe. Paramatma is the siddhanta. Pradhana jiva iti purvapaksha. Pradhana or jiva are the upasya in the different purvapakshas. Siddhantastu iha adhidaivadishu shruyamana antaryami paramatma. Kutaha taddharma yapadeshat. Why? Because his dharmas are talked about, gunas are discussed as what? Sarvantaryami. Sarvantaryami. Not, not even a single antaryami. Sarvantaryamitva, atmatva, amrutatvadeha. All these gunas are sadharana only to, although they sadharana, tesham iha vyapadesha. These dharmas which are talked about, they are possible only in Paramatma. I'll just conclude soon, two, three sutras. So, nanu pradhana antaryamyastu ityashankya. Why not pradhana? Nacha smartam atadharma pilapat. Because smarta meaning the Sankhya creator, Rishi, has a smriti. That smriti shows that pradhana is the jagat karana also, and that can be upasya. So smriti kalpitam, Sankhyam is what? Smartam is Sankhyam, smriti kalpitam, pradhanam, that is not antaryami. Why? Kuta? Atadharma apilapat. Basically, pradhana is what? It is achetana. Achetana cannot be doing anything. Any controlling is... It cannot be doing any controlling. There is no controlling possible for an achetana vastu. Tasyeva chetanasye dharmaha adrishtaha drishtashrutaha shrota iti vakyasheshe shruyamana drishtrutvadayaha. All these gunas which are talked about, drishtrutvam ityadi, all those are what? These are possible only in the case of achetana, achetana, not in the case of achetana, smarta. Even if it is smarta, it is not achetana pradhana. Nanutari chetana jiva yogi bhavatu antaryamityata. Yogi, a siddhi yogi can be the upasya here. So he is chetana. There what is the problem? Sharirascha ubhayapihi bhedena ainam adhiyate. So there, the answer is shariraha na antaryami. Antaryami is not possible. So there is a anuvritti of anushanga, anuvritti of the na antaryami from the earlier sutra, 19th sutra. Kasmat ubhaya piyo vijnane tishtan iti kanvaha ya atmane tishtan iti madhyandinaha. So in the both the pathas, in the kanva shakha as well as madhyandina shakha, all the bhedas in the Patabheda also, two different shakhas also, what has been talked about? Ubhayapi, yo vijnane tishtan and ya atmani tishtan. Iti, the antaryami which has been talked about, bhedena enam adhiyate. They both chant in the both the pathas, there is a chanting of ya antar atmani tishtan and yo vijnane tishtan. Vijnana is jiva, atma is also jiva there. So, yaha tasmin. Jive tishtan, one who is there as an inner control, antaryami, sitting in this jiva, cannot be the jiva, cannot be the sharira jiva. Same reason, there is a bheda, because one is the support, the other is within him. One upasya, the upasya is within the jiva who is upasaka. So, paramatma eva. Adrishyatvadi gunako dharmoktehe, in this adhikarana, adrishyatvadi, all these gunas are adrishyatva, all these are dharmas which are applicable only to Paramatma. So yattad adrishyam, all these are adrishyatva gunas. So pradhana sharira says the purva paksha, in that sandeha there is a response. To that sandeha there is a response, siddhantastu. Yattad adrishyam ityadi shruta adrishyatvadeya guna yasya sa adrishyatvadi gunakaha. That gunaka is who? Bhuta yonihi paramatma eva. That bhuta yoni is paramatma, bhuta karana. Bhutanam karana is paramatma only. Kutaha dharmokte hai. His dharmas are discussed. Yaha sarvajnya sarvavita ityadi. Sarvajnya and sarvavit cannot be jiva. Cannot, definitely not pradhana, because jnana can take place only in a sentient entity. Pradhana is insentient. Then what about jiva? Oh, jiva cannot be sarvajnya and sarvavit. Sarvam janati samanyataya iti sarvajnya. And sarvam vetti visheshata api iti sarvavit. One who knows samanya as well as vishesha. Even if Purvapakshi claims as yogi has this possibility of knowing everything. Yes, yogi can be sarvajnya but cannot be sarvavit. Yogi can be sarvajnya means samanyata he can know. But he can know each and every detail of everyone. He cannot be sarvavit. Therefore, even shariraha, yogi, siddhi, siddha jiva cannot be sarvajnya sarvavit. Therefore, it has to be paramatma alone. भूतयोने परमात्मत्वे हेत्वंतरमाह विशेषण भेद व्यपदेशाभ्याम चनेतरौ. सो देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ अदर्स न इतरौ. परमात्मा भिन्न, देर कैन नॉट बी अदर्स. वाई? विशेषण भेद व्यपदेशाभ्याम. विशेषण भेद व्यपदेशौ ताभ्याम इतरौ प्रधान जीव. इतर इज प्रधान एंड जीव. कैन नॉट बी भूतयोनीज. वाई? बिकॉज दिस विशेषण भेद, विशेषण भेद व्यपदेश विशेषण भेद व्यपदेशौ ताभ्याम, बिकॉज ताभ्याम हेतुभ्याम इतरौ प्रधान जीवौ न भूतयोनि भवतः. दे दिव्यो ह्यमूर्तः पुरुष इत्यादिना. सो ऑल दिस दिव्यत्व आदि विशेषणाज आर गिवन. दे बिकम दि धर्मास, दि दिव्यत्वम, अमूर्तत्वम, ऑल दीज धर्माज आर पॉसिबल ओनली. विशेषणाज एज धर्माज आर पॉसिबल ओनली फॉर परमात्मा, नॉट फॉर जीवा और प्रधान. सो लास्ट वन दैट वी लुक्ड एट वाज रूपोपन्यासाच्च. सो भूतयोनेः परमात्मत्वे हेत्वंतरः रूपोपन्यासाच्च. बिकॉज दी अग्निर्मूर्धा चक्षुषी चंद्रसूर्यौ. देयर इज अ टाइपो हियर, दिस शुड बी सूर्यौ द्विवचन. सो अग्निः इज मूर्धा एंड चक्षु. चक्षुज आर चंद्र एंड सूर्य. चंद्र एंड सूर्याज आर दी आईज एंड अग्नि इज मूर्धा, the head. So when you talk about this kind of an upasana also, it has to be paramatma. It cannot be jiva. Jiva cannot have, he can be hot headed but not agni as his head. And chandra and surya cannot be jiva's eyes. Therefore also paramatma eva bhutayoni iti iti vrittikaramatam. Then also vrittikaramatam, but then paramatma eva bhutayoni, due to what reason, that has been explained. Vrittikara mata purusha eva idam vishvam karma ityadi sarvatmatva rupa upanyasat paramatma eva bhutayoni riti bhagavatpadiya matam. The difference we had seen, there was a question regarding this also. The difference is that one is karyatmaka. The vrittikara takes that the agni and chandra surya are karyas and they are paramatma's karyas and paramatma is the upasya in this manner. But then the bhagavatpadiya matam, Bhagavan Shankaracharya says that the agni and murda and chakshu being chandra surya, this chandra surya being chakshus, this is the swarupa of all the prapancha. Agni and chandra and surya, they are all swarupata brahma. Therefore the paramatma eva इति सर्वात्मत्व, मीनिंग दी परमात्मा हिमसेल्फ अपीयर्स एज दी एज अग्नि एंड चंद्र सूर्य. विद दैट अंडरस्टैंडिंग इफ यू डू उपासना, देन परमात्मा इज उपास्य विद दैट ज्ञान ऑफ स्वरूप ज्ञान. दिस इज द डिफरेंस एज भूतयोनि बीइंग भगवत्पादीय मतम. बट द कंक्लूजन इज सेम इन बोथ केसेस. द हेतु इज स्लाइटली डिफरेंट टू लैंड ऑन दैट परमात्मा एज उपास्य. So this is the recap. We'll continue with the 24th sutra in the next part. Since it has been a long gap, we did a recap. Amnayante ka samsiddham adi madhyanta varjitam ananda ghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasme om tat sat. Namaskara, dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Thank you.